I wanted to introduce you to somebody, kind of went off our regular course here. I wanted to introduce you to a retired police officer. His name is Ken Hogan, and he was a cop in Irvington. He was shot 19 times, and just a truthfully one of the great New Jersey heroes. And Officer Ken Hogan joins us now. Morning, Ken. How are you?
Good morning, sir. Just want to clarify, Bill. I was shot at over 19 times. I was hit 4
okay
times. So
it just goes to show, though. Now, this was a drug suspect, right? Can you walk me through that day? I mean, I try to tell people there's no such thing, and you know this, as a routine anything when it comes to what police officers encounter on a day-to-day basis. So what happened that day? This was 1994.
Exactly. It was like any other day. You know, like, we leave our homes, we go to a place where we can die, and we all know that. Every one of us that puts the badge on knows it. On that particular morning, it was about 9:15 in the morning. I seen a drug kid walking down. He went to buy some drugs at a drug house. I went to stop him, and he spun around. He had a 6-hour 9mm handgun loaded up to go, jacket at hollow points. And when he spun around, the first round came through the windshield at 12 o'clock, missed me. He fired a bunch more, and then he walked up to the car as I laid on the floor, and he pumped 4 more into me. The first round hit me in the finger, shot my finger off. Then he shot me in the shoulder. The round went through my bulletproof vest into my shoulder.
Oh my God.
The next round went through my bulletproof vest into my spine, and then he leaned into the police car and put that final round into my head, and it was lights out at that point.
Wow. So you've got a clear memory of this guy standing over you, putting bullets into you.
Bill, let me tell you, it's been a long time, but I live through it every single day that I wake up. And I remember him looking me in the eye as he started to shoot. I remember hitting the floor, and then I remember, you know, his last round going through my head like it was yesterday. And, you know, it's been a long road to recover, but, you know, I was out for 2 years, and I went back to the job and did 12 more, for the beautiful people of Irvington, New Jersey.
Wow. You came back. You came back.
Yeah, I went back to work. Yeah.
It's incredible. I mean, what was it like that first day back on the job?
It was a little tense at first,
yeah.
You know, but you know your brain and your abilities, if you have the heart of a police officer, your brain and your abilities will always say to you, you can do this, and there's nothing that can stop you. And as long as you have that kind of ability, which I did and a lot of cops do have, you know, it was somewhat scary, but at the same time rewarding.
What do you tell cops? I know you're out there lecturing. You talk at a lot of 200 clubs, and you're out there helping cops kind of take that next step, move forward, and deal with some of the things they have to deal with. What do you tell them? I mean, what else can be done in a situation like that?
Well, you know, it's all about drive. It's all about, you know, your ability to have a plan prior to, you know, doing whatever it is police officers do on a daily basis, whether it's a traffic stop or a domestic violence. You have to have a plan. And the plan doesn't just end at the end of that car stop or that domestic violence. It goes on in your personal life, and you always have to be able to look forward. If something were to happen, you have to literally, you know, get up off your feet and move forward at every cost, whether it's, you know, physical or mental. You know, as long as you could have a plan prior to, you know, coming across an incident, then, you know, I try to tell every single police officer, especially the young guys, that having a plan, having the ability to get up and move forward is what's going to keep you going and keep you alive.
Wow. It's such a powerful story, and it's an important one to be shared. I want to stay in touch with you because I see you're doing a lot of great work around. Somebody wanted me to ask you about a movie you made.
Yeah, it was going back some time ago, Blue Force Films. It's Donna Roman. She's a retired captain out of Caldwell, New Jersey. She does a great job with getting our stories out there, police officers that are shot. She does an awesome job, and she definitely deserves some kudos to getting, you know, my story out and other police officers who have been shot in the line of duty.
Can I post a link? I'd love to post a link to that on 101.5. So if when we hang up in a second or so, if you can just give that information to Kristen, I'd love to put that as a part of our hashtag Blue Friday post today.
Yeah,
your story's incredible. I don't know, maybe what happened to the guy? What happened to the guy that shot you?
He literally walked across the street believing that he killed me because he left me in the car for dead, but he walked across the street and he took his own life.
Really?
Yeah.
It's just
he killed himself thinking he killed me, and, you know, God rest his soul. And I pray for him every day. Yeah. And good for you. I forgive him, and that's, you know, just the way it is.
God, yeah, it gives me chills. I mean, it's like we need more people like you. I knew your story was one that had to be told on Blue Friday, and I appreciate you joining me today, Ken. And thank God you're okay. Oh, and congratulations. I read that you recently got married, at least within the last couple of years.
No, I've been married for about 24 years.
Oh, you're kidding.
Yeah,
I see that? You don't know.
I got married 40 days after I got
this shot. This is why you can't believe everything you read. This is the problem. That was fake news. But
I actually got shot 40 days. I walked my wife down the aisle 40 days after.
Did you
I got
really?
Shot.
Yeah. How was that? I can't even imagine that. It must have been years of pain,
yeah,
I'm sure.
Yeah, you know, I try to tell people, try living with a headache for, you know, 21 or 22 months, having a headache every day for 22 months, and it not go away.
It is a true miracle that you didn't die that day.
Yeah, listen, God's with me, and God's with all your listeners, and every single police officer and emergency medical personnel and firefighters. You know, we love what you're doing on 101.5, and I can't thank you enough for, you know, all your support and the support of all of us in law enforcement. And, you know, that's
thanks,
great.
Ken. I appreciate that, but, you know, I'm just here to point out the true heroes, and you're one of them, and thank you for being here.